Hi everybody, I'm Naufal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss regarding measles. So measles is also known as rubeola. Measles is also known as rubeola, which means red spot. So what is mean by measles? Measles is a condition that is occurring in the childhood. It's a disease that is occurring in the childhood caused by paramyxovirus. It is a disease of childhood caused by paramyxovirus. Next, we can see regarding the definition of measles. So the definition of measles is, it is an acute, highly infectious disease of the childhood caused by specific virus of paramyxovirus. Paramyxovirus. So the definition is, it is an acute, that is a short-term, highly infectious disease of childhood caused by specific virus of paramyxovirus. That is the definition of the measles. Next, we can see regarding the epidemiological factors. Regarding the epidemiological factors, mainly three things we can see. That is the agent, the host, and the environment. First, we can see regarding the agent. The agent of measles is RNA virus of paramyxo group or the paramyxovirus. Okay, RNA virus of the paramyxo group is the agent of the reason of this measles is this virus. That is the paramyxo virus or the RNA virus of paramyxo group. That is the agent of the measles. Next, we can see regarding the source of infection. The source of infection is a case of measles. That is the infected child with measles is the only source of measles. From an infected child only, other child is getting the infection. That is the source. And regarding the infective material, regarding the infective material is the discharges from the nose, from the throat, and the respiratory, upper respiratory tract of the infected child. The discharges from the nose, throat, and the upper respiratory tract of the infected child is the infective material in the measles. And regarding the period of communicability, when this disease will spread from one child to another. It is mainly spreading 4 days before the appearance of the rashes as well as 4 days after the appearance of the rashes. 4 days before the appearance of the rashes as well as 4 days after the appearance of the rashes. It will spread. Okay, commonly it will spread during these 4 days before the appearance of the rash as well as the after the appearance of the rash. Next, we can see regarding the host factor. Coming under the epidemiological features, next one is host factor. So to whom this measles is affecting? In developing countries, it is affecting the child between the age of 6 months to 3 years. In developing countries, it is affecting the child between the age of 6 months to 3 years. But in developed countries, it is affecting mainly children above 5 years. Children above 5 years in developed country. And it is affecting the both sexes. That is the boy as well as the girl. It is affecting the both sex. And mainly it is affecting the malnourished child. This condition is mainly affecting malnourished child. Now we can see regarding the environmental factors. Regarding the environmental factors, this disease is seen in all climate or all season. You can see this disease, but mainly you can see this disease in winter season as well as in early spring. Mainly you can see this disease in winter as well as early spring. The most spread you can see in this season. Okay, next we can see regarding the mode of transmission. How this disease is spreading from one person to another person. How it is transmitted from one person to another person. That is the mode of transmission. So it is mainly through person to person contact. It is the contact between an infected person and a normal person. Through the droplet infection. That is through the drops. Through the coughing or the sneezing, that drop will enter to the body of the normal person as well as through the droplet nuclei. Through the droplet nuclei. Droplet nuclei is nothing. It is the waste product of the drops, the waste product of the drops. That means the tiny particles of the cough and sneeze, it will be there in the environment. After coughing or sneezing, the waste particle or the tiny particle will be there in the environment. And it is highly infectious. So, through the droplet infection as well as through the droplet nuclei, this disease will transfer from another person to one person to another person. Okay. Now, we can see regarding the incubation period of measles. The incubation period of measles is between 10 to 14 days. The incubation period is between 10 to 14 days. Okay. Now, we can see regarding the clinical features of measles. So, mainly the clinical features is divided into three stages, that is prodromal stage, eruptive stage and post measles stage. Prodromal stage is also known as pre-eruptive stage, that is before the appearance of the rashes, that is pre-eruptive. Second stage is eruptive stage, that is after the appearance of the rashes, and the last one is post measles stage. We can see one by one, prodromal stage or pre-eruptive stage. In that, mainly 3C you can see, the clinical feature, 3Cs are there, that is the cough, coryza, conjunctivitis, then photophobia, fever and Kopliks spot. Cough, coryza. So, what is coryza? Coryza is nothing, it is just like the common cold. Okay, it is the inflammation of the upper respiratory tract. The symptoms include discharges from the nose, watering of the eyes and sneezing. Okay, just like common cold only, it's a medical term. For the common cold, it is coryza, inflammation of the upper respiratory tract. Discharge from the nose, watering of the eyes and sneezing are the common symptoms. Then conjunctivitis. Conjunctivitis is the inflammation of the conjunctiva of the eyes. Next one is photophobia. Photophobia means intolerance to light. That means discomfort of the eyes to sharp light. Discomfort of the eyes to sharp light or the intolerance to light. That is photophobia. Next one is fever. And last one is very important thing you have to note in the measles, Kopliks spot. Kopliks spot. It is a small bluish white spot on red background, which is seen inside the mouth in the inner lining of the cheek. So, what is Kopliks spot? Kopliks spot is the small bluish white spot on red background, which is seen inside the mouth of the inner lining of the cheek. Okay, a bluish white spot on the red background, which is seen inside the mouth in the inner lining of the cheek. That is Kopliks spot, which is seen in the first stage of the measles. Now, next stage in the clinical feature is eruptive stage, that is after the appearance of the rashes. Here the rashes will be there. So, the thing is red maculopapular rash. You can see red maculopapular rash starting from the ear, then to the face, then to the neck, then to all over the body within 2 to 3 days. So, red maculopapular rash. So, what is mean by maculopapular rash? Macule and the papule, that is maculopapular. Macule and papule. So, what is mean by macule? Macule is nothing. It is the flat surface of the rash. The flat surface of the rash is macule. So, what is papule? Papule means the raised or the elevated portion of the rash. Okay, the elevated portion of the rash is papule. So, the flat surface is macule and the elevated, the rise part is papule in the rash. So, here in measles you can see both, that is maculopapular rash, red maculopapular rash. It will start from the ear, then to the face, then to the neck, then slowly to all over the body within 2 to 3 days. From the ear, it will spread soon to the face and the neck. But from here, within 2 to 3 days, all over the body, it will spread in the second stage, the clinical feature. Next, we can see the next stage, that is the post-measles stage. So, here the signs and symptoms are weakness and weight loss. Weight loss will be there and weakness will be there. Next one is diarrhea and next one is cancrum oris. Cancrum oris, which means the ulceration of the mouth. Ulceration of the mouth, which is seen in the measles, that is cancrum ORIs, the gangrenous ulceration of the mouth, which is seen in measles. So keep it in mind, it is ulceration of the mouth seen in measles, that is cancrum oris. Next one is pyogenic infections. Pyogenic infections are commonly caused by bacteria, leads to production of the pus. It is commonly caused by bacteria, leads to production of the pus, that is pyogenic infection. Next, we can see regarding the diagnostic evaluation or diagnostic measures, how to diagnose measles. That is through the history collection, physical examination. During the physical examination, this Kopliks spot is a good evidence to diagnose the measles. Kopliks spot is a good evidence to diagnose the measles during the physical examination, as well as if required, we can do the cell culture also. Next, we can see regarding the treatment of the measles. There is no a proper treatment for the measles regarding the antiviral drugs and all. There is no a proper drug for the measles. Symptomatic treatment we can give. For the fever, we can give the antipyretics, as well as advise the child to drink plenty of water, as well as in case of pyogenic or the bacterial infection, we can give antibiotics. Next, we can see regarding the prevention of measles, how we can prevent measles. Mainly, we can prevent the measles through vaccination, that is through immunization. So we can give the measles vaccine. The first dose should be given between 9 to 12 month of age. The first dose of the measles vaccine should be given between 9 to 12 month of age. This vaccine we are giving through the subcutaneous route during the 9 to 12 month of age, and the second dose we are giving at the month of 16 to 24 months of age. Between 16 to 24 month of age, the second dose of the measles we can give. We can give the measles vaccine along with the mumps, measles and rubella vaccine as a combination also we can give. The vaccine for the measles is a live vaccine. Okay, live vaccine we are using. So regarding the vaccination, two doses, and regarding the month, 9 to 12 month first dose, and regarding the second dose between 16 to 24 month of age. Okay, next one is regarding the prevention is immunoglobulin. We can give immunoglobulin also 0.25 ml. Okay, we can give 0.25 ml per kg body weight. 0.25 ml per kg body weight immunoglobulin we can give within 3 to 4 days of exposure. If there is a contact with a measles case, within 3 to 4 days we have to give the immunoglobulin 0.25 ml per kg body weight we have to give. Nowadays it is not much important because vaccine is available, as well as vaccine is highly effective. That is regarding the prevention. Next, we can see regarding the control of the measles, how to control the measles. So regarding the control of the measles, in case a infected person is there, we have to isolate them for 7 days after the appearance of the rashes. After the appearance of the rash, we have to isolate them 7 days. Next one is vaccination should be given to the contact. If you had a contact with a measles case, vaccination should be given within 2 days. If vaccine is contraindicated, we have to give the immunoglobulin within 3 to 4 days. We have to give immunoglobulin if the vaccine is contraindicated. Next, we have to protect the eyes of the child from light. Protect the eyes of the child from light because photophobia will be there. Next one is we have to disinfect the discharges from the nose and the throat, as well as from the respiratory tract of the infected person, especially the clothes as well as the utensils they are using. That's all regarding the measles. We will meet soon with another video. Till that time, thank you and goodbye.